we want to simplify the expressions with rational exponents. So even though our exponents are fractions, we're still going to be applying the basic rules for exponents, which are given here in red for reference. So looking at the first example, we have x to the power of 1/3 times x to the power of 1/4, and since we're multiplying and the bases are the same, we need to add the exponents. So this is equal to x to the power of 1/3 plus 1/4. But we know in order to add fractions, we have to have a common denominator. And if our denominators are 3 and 4, the LCD, or least common denominator, would be 12. So we can multiply this first fraction by 4 over 4, and multiply the second fraction by 3 over 3. And notice how now we have a common denominator of 12. This becomes x to the power of 4/12 plus 3/12. So this simplifies to x to the power of 7/12. Looking at the second example, we're dividing and the bases are the same. So now we need to subtract the exponents. So this would be equal to m to the power of 5/6 minus 2/5. And again, when we're subtracting fractions, we have to have a common denominator. And in this case, since the denominators are 6 and 5, the least common denominator would be 30. So we're going to multiply this first fraction by 5 over 5, multiply the second fraction by 6 over 6. So now we'll have m to the power of, this will be 25/30, minus this would be 12/30. And now that we have a common denominator we can subtract, this is going to be equal to m to the power of 13/30. And then for the third example, we have powers raised to powers. So we're going to multiply the exponents. So here we're going to have a to the power of 6 times negative 1/3, b to the power of 4 times negative 1/3. And to determine these products, let's go ahead and put the 6 over 1 and 4 over 1. So here, notice the 3 and the 6 simplify. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. So we have a to the negative 2, and b to the power of, nothing simplifies here, so we'll just have a power of negative 4/3. But we can't leave this expression with negative exponents. So if we think of this as a fraction with a denominator of 1, if we move a to the negative 2 to the denominator, it'll become a to the positive 2. And if we move b to the negative 4/3 to the denominator, it'll become b to the positive 4/3. So this will leave us with 1 all over a to the second b to the power of 4/3. OK, I hope you found these examples helpful.